morning, y'all.
Yeah, it's morning. It's Monday morning, and I'm a couple of days behind on vlogging. However, y'all know I'm making it up to you. You know I am. I did that prank last night. I sure did. That was an epic fail, y'all. I'll tell you why it was an epic fail. Because James made me feel bad. He did. He made me feel bad. He was like, Steph, you will not like that shit if somebody did that to you. He ain't lying. I wouldn't. I'll be like going off. Like, for real. You're like, Steph, what the hell is you doing? I found my black mommy wig and she looked a little matted. So I just bought her ass back to life. I sure did. I just put her in the sink and washed her with some shampoo. I sure did. And I'm just brushing her back so she can get her waves. Cause y'all know the mommy wig, she kind of like all waved up. And yeah, I gotta order that blonde one. I said I was gonna order that blonde one today. I ordered that blonde one. I might as well order my mama one too, cause y'all, she like blonde hair too. That'll just be an extra Christmas present for her. Yeah, mom, I said that. Anywho, yesterday, your girl was, I was out of the loop because I'm on the injured sick list, okay? I was, and when I say injured sick list, I'm talking about the, that bitch I can't stand, that chick. Huh. And she took me out of commission, honey. I had a headache. I had cramps. Like, what's that movie? I'm gonna get you, sucker. Cramps. Yeah, I had those, y'all. I was like on 10. Oh my gosh, I was on 10. So, everything that I had planned to do yesterday, shit, what I planned to do the whole weekend didn't get done. I wanted to go ice skating in Philly. You know, that's what I wanted to do. But the weather kind of like took away from it, like for real, because who wants to go ice skating and it's raining outside? Not I, okay? Not I. I'm not trying to get cold in my body, okay? Because I'm allowing myself to get wet. And I'm okay with it. Nah, player. So, y'all, remember all them baskets of clothes I had downstairs like a week ago? Well, I had some progress. The baskets made it upstairs to this main closet. Y'all probably like, girl, really? Really? It did. They made it up here. And usually, y'all, I would pay somebody. I would pay one of them to put my clothes up. But they do such a horrible job doing it. Mm-mm. Because y'all won't be able to find shit. And y'all already know I get mad about stuff like that. So, you know what? If you're going to get mad about it, just do it your damn self. And so, I did that. Hence, now y'all see me looking for hangers. It's normally not a challenge. It's not. But, yeah. So, this is going to get worn this week. Right here. Because we're having another sequins day. And y'all know what it's, for my photo shoot. For my, 42nd birthday. Now I was showing y'all, child, you could be in your 40s and be fly too. That's gonna debut again, either that or the rainbow sequin pants. Y'all tell me which one y'all think I should wear. The rainbow sequins pants or I should wear that. Y'all let me know. I'm gonna let y'all dress me for that day. Hey, rainbow sequins pants, I'm gonna kill y'all. I'm gonna kill. Hello? Not yet, Jada. I will.
Okay, Mom.
And I'll text you where it is.
Okay.
All right. Have a great day at school. And you better apologize to that teacher.
I already had her. I'm at Volk right now. I just got to
go. Okay. Don't play with me, little girl. Don't. You've been doing so good. Don't backslide.
Okay, Mom.
All right.
I won't.
Okay.
Promise.
All right.
See you later.
Because I ain't putting another gift under that tree until I see that grade go up.
Okay.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Don't play. Mm-mm. Don't play no radios. So, I'm like embarrassed to show y'all this closet right now because she not together. That's what my bed looking like right now because I'm putting all these things up and yeah, they're not together. So, let me finish getting my life together, literally. Because I gotta hang, this is the pile that needs to get hung. Pile of t-shirts. And then I'm gonna talk to y'all today about how to get on that exclusive list for me to be your personal shopper. Okay? And the exclusive list is called The Few. And if you wanna know what that means, Fly Eclectic Women. We are. So y'all, I have so much going on in my mind that it's been a little difficult for me to sleep. And I feel like I need to go buy a new notebook today so I can have new and put all the new thoughts in the new notebook. Do you feel me? Yeah, you feel me. Let me get my life because I gotta finish this. Because my husband was looking at me crazy yesterday because he was like, Steph, I thought you was gone. Put the clothes up. Because when I put these clothes up, I also got laundry to start. Shame on me. But y'all, I work a lot. And I ain't just talking about working at Primark, YouTube, my Eclectnista Poshmark closet, my website I need to update. That's like the thing I probably gonna put off the most. Because my webographer, which is Jazz, she been working like crazy too. And y'all, we got two more weeks. We got this week of Christmas and next week after Christmas. And freedom. Freedom! Oh, y'all, I was thinking about the Beyonce song. I'm gonna holler at y'all. Bam! It's Christmas. Y'all, it is the week before Christmas. And yes, I am definitely in the festive mood, honey. I am. And I cannot get the back of my dress buttoned. So I'm going to wait till I get to work. And I'm going to show y'all how my outfit came out. What? You better show me too. Okay, so I have my Santa Claus hat and stocking dress. I have on my little stockings. Okay. A little peekaboo action. Okay, Justin Kai. You know what I'm saying? Then I was gonna put on my diva hat, but the dress is about the hats, okay? It's about the hats and stockings. So I chose to put this one on. Now, I don't want my hair to be flat. I want it to be fluffy. So I don't want to sit my hat like all the way down. Because I also don't want makeup to get on it. So feeling flat, feeling the Christmas spirit, I am. And I'm getting ready to get out this house. Also, have y'all finished y'all Christmas shopping yet? I got a few more gifts to pick up. I got my mom out the way. I gotta get my mother-in-law out the way now. And then I think we're working on something for my father-in-law. And then the girls, I need to get them the read concept. I need to get Jada the need and read. I need to get Mr. Long the read and need. Oh, and then I'm a secret Santa to someone at work. And y'all, it just dawned on me this morning when I was cleaning out my closet, or, you know, hanging stuff up in my closet. I realized something that she would want from me. Now, I'm gonna have to be very disciplined this week to pull this off, because y'all, it is requiring me to be crafty. Yeah. And then tomorrow I gotta go get a basket for my husband's principal's gift. And I gotta wrap all that stuff up. I got a lot to do. Oh God, I hate when perfume get in your mouth. I hate it. However, y'all, let me go. Put these keys up for Jada, because y'all heard her earlier, right? She left her keys at home. I ain't got time to go out to her school. She loved when I come out there, though. Come out, they be like, your mama bad. She be like, I know, trust me, I know. And my daddy know, too. they be taking off for Mr. Long, okay? But she also was like, I told her, girl, that's how you gotta be. You gotta be whore. You gotta make the boys. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. They're like, it's better than yours. Child, you ain't got to play into that, okay? So, let me get my phone. Let me get this charger. And then when I get in the car, I will holla at y'all. All right, y'all. I just attempted to go to the post office, and y'all, it was a line out the door, okay? And I was just going to pick something up. One of y'all sent me a gift, and she was like, Steph, have you got it yet? Saturday, I was out of commission. Because, you know, I slept all day. Sunday, the post office ain't open. And as I tried to go before I went to work, I left a little earlier than I normally leave. But, child, it is, the line was out the door. So, now that I know, first thing in the morning, soon as they open, my ass will be there. Because tomorrow, I'm going to have some stuff to give away. Hey! I'm going to have some stuff to mail out. How about that? Y'all, this hat is hot as hell. I don't even care. I don't. Because you know what? I'm in the Christmas spirit. One day I was like, Steph, you sure is happy. You want to know why? Life is good. Oh, snap. Don't y'all hate when rocks be spitting off of people's cars and ish? Like, damn. Anywho, life is good. Life is good. This year, it's been on, off, up, down. However, I'm happy to say, as of the 17th of December, I think I'm going to be ending the year on the up. And no regrets of anything, like, you know, hardships, decisions, or anything like that. It is what it damn is, you feel me? However, brand new year, and I really don't have any resolutions this year. Y'all, I have goals. I have some goals that I'm going to give myself 90-day increments for each goal. And I ain't talking about losing no weight, because y'all, that's gonna happen regardless. And that's something we do every year. I'm happy that I'm down 20 pounds, I'm gonna tell you that, and I'm gonna work on the next 20. Oh, I wonder what I'm gonna look like with 20 more off of me. Fine as fuck! That's how I'm gonna look! I'll be back in all those jeans. all of those jeans, and I'll be I'm gonna be snatched this summer because of me being a healthier me, learning, because this is something you have to learn, learning balance and learning how to prioritize and what's important. And I'm so serious with y'all, like today I feel like today is the day that I need to go buy like a new notebook, a new pen, just for me to write down all of my 2019 goals and new planner, and like let's just get ready for 2019, because y'all, it's about to be popping, it's about to be lit, and I'm excited for it. Like, woo! I felt this sense of expectancy before, but it's something different, y'all. It is something different in the air this time around, okay? It is. God has like ignited something in me, and He is telling me it's your time. Seize it. Seize the moment. And you can't be shy. This is the wrong time to be acting shy, feeling like, you know, you can't do what you do. No. He said it's the wrong time. Continue being you and watch where you take yourself. Hallelujah. So y'all, while I was getting dressed, I was supposed to be talking to y'all and telling y'all how to get into this exclusive group called The Few, okay? Yet I got tied up in watching a YouTuber that I watch, and I've mentioned her before to y'all. And y'all, I am so happy she showed up in my recommendations, because I was looking for my own damn vlog, y'all, because I tell y'all I watch it. Once it go live, I watch it so I can make sure I'm straight, right? Like, ain't nothing I need to take out or something like that. However, she showed up and I saw that she left her husband. Y'all, Life of the Cassells, and I think her name is Kyra, I think that is it. Pretty beautiful, beautiful woman. Y'all, military wife, and she finally said enough is enough. Some theme music, honey. I'll dance now. I make money moves. I ain't gotta dance. I make money moves. If you see me and I don't speak, you know I don't fuck with you. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all, she is brand spanking new. Like, I think, like, I'm gonna binge watch her vlogmas, because I saw, I watched day one of Vlogmas, and that's when she said they were officially separated. And then I just see, like, she wasn't fucking around, y'all. She was dead ass serious. And she was like, bye, Derek. I don't know what her husband's name is, but I think it is something with a D. But bye. Y'all, I did not like the way he treated her. I didn't like the way she allowed him to treat her either. Because like I said to y'all before, people only treat us how we allow them to. You give people permission, you allow them to speak to you in any type of tone, way, fashion, form. They you're letting people like ruin your life. And y'all know they always say, don't allow people to rent space in your head, because when they do, they have control over you. And I finally think she said, I'm tired. I don't know exactly what it was that pushed her over the edge, because she kept saying that she didn't want to talk about it in the video that I saw. I got through Vlogmas, I think, 1 and 2. Yet, I'm just like, good for you. I am not about marriages breaking up and tearing apart and stuff like that. I don't condone that. However, I don't condone somebody being unhappy. I don't condone that. Everybody needs to be happy and have a happy place in a happy space with a happy person. Do you feel me? And if your spouse is not doing that and your spouse is putting you in a negative space and talking down on you and making you feel like you're nothing, that's verbal abuse, y'all. It's verbal, it's emotional, and it's just wrong. And she did a lot. Like, she took on his children that he had from his prior baby mama, took care of them. She just had another baby, and she good. Cause child, just his demeanor, like, y'all, this is the things that as a military spouse, I'm not gonna just say wife, I'm gonna say spouse, because you know, it could be the husband, it could be a woman's wife, you know, it could be a man's husband, because y'all know they are allowed to have those type of marriages now, you know. I don't know what's the correct term for it, however, they are able to have those type of marriages. Y'all get what I'm trying to say. I want to be politically correct, okay? Yet, the military spouse and the soldier, there's always been a stereotype where, you know, they think it's the husband cheating or the wife cheating. And she says it's not, it has nothing to do with him cheating or her cheating per se. Like I said, y'all, we don't know what happens behind people's closed doors. We don't. But from what she's shared and what I've saw so far, I just think it was the way he treated her, you know? Them vows say, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health. It says to respect, you know? I'm not opposed to the obey and the things, because I do believe that my husband is the head of my household. However, he don't, okay? He says that we, yet I'm going to always uplift him and put him as the man of the house, and he is the head of our household. And it says it in the Bible, that's what it's supposed to be. The wife is the spouse is the self-mate. Wait, am I saying it right? The self-mate. The help-me. The wife, the spouse is the help-me. And I am here to help him in his times of need. And I am here to support him, you know, nourish him, feed him, love him emotionally, physically, mentally. I'm here to strengthen him, uplift him, you know. When he's down, I am there to pick him up. And damn it, y'all, all of that I just said, I expect my husband to be that to me too. And I just don't think she had that from what we see. You know what I'm saying? But you know what? Good for her. Good for her. Kyra, if you are watching this, good for you, honey. That was a leap of faith that you took, and you said enough was enough. And God is going to bless another man to come into your life, and you are going to, you know what wrong look like, or you know what ain't quite right look like. Now he's gonna show you what right look like. And you know what? Your husband is going to regret that the woman he had, he ain't treated like his queen. He didn't. He treated her like she was the nanny or the maid or the help. Come on now. I'm glad she finally said enough is enough. And from what I saw, like just glancing through the titles, she moved to Virginia. So she left his ass high and dry. And I'ma pray for them, because you know that's hard on, it's hard on both of them. Yet it's hard on the children, because now the family is divided. And I really wonder how that part is gonna play out. Like, I don't know if she took all the children with her, because he has custody of his older boys. I don't know, but I'm gonna pray for them, because before it gets better, it's going to get worse. And they say in divorce, you could love someone so much. Ooh, to the ends of the earth. They say divorce will bring out the ugly, the evil, and you'll be like, who the hell are you? Okay? I'm gonna pray for her though. I am. And pray for him too. Because, honey, his child support is about to be off the damn chain. Okay? Y'all, I'm gonna holler at y'all. My phone ringing. My baby daddy calling me. Holla. I bring me. Hello?
Hey.
Hi, honey.
You on your way to work?
Yes, sir. All right, y'all. I'm feeling real festive today. It's the week of Christmas, baby. Bring out your Christmas spirit. Told y'all I'm in a festive mood today. Really am. Got him stepping out of his element. Because he don't normally wear nobody but Nike. I'm getting ready to leave.
Like, bitch, I
want to
leave.
And Ashley looked like a whole Christmas tree today. I'm the stocking and she the tree. Look at the tree. That is the Christmas tree. Oh, give up. Give up. And Sandra saying, could y'all help us hurry up?
It came off.
What do you mean?
No, look, it came off.
Oh. Hold up. Wait a minute.
I'm picking it up.
My what? I'm going to Target, but I'm going home.
I think you're going to get the brown version of that jacket.
I bought this 2 years ago from Primark.
Oh, shit.
Exactly.
Oh,
good. Time to go. For real, though. OMG. When I tell y'all, I cannot wait for this week to be over. I can't. That's all I'm gonna say. I can't wait. Anywho, I didn't want to be rude and not come back and say goodnight because y'all, it is literally 12:27 and I'm tired. And I left my notebook in the car with my notes for this exclusive list. So forgive me, please. Please forgive me. I need y'all to understand. Your girl is tired, okay? I'm off tomorrow and I'm not going back outside. I'm just not. I left right on the car, on the seat. I ain't going back out though. Anywho, we will discuss this tomorrow and I will be more specific. And I hope you guys had a blessed night. I had a pretty okay day. My internal weather almost changed. And I had to remember, I cannot allow other people to affect me, who I am, what I stand for, and I just can't let people change my weather. I just can't, y'all. So today I had to approach something and put it out there, and I think I did the right thing and it didn't affect the rest of my day. Say what you gotta say, mean what you say, be firm about it, and keep it moving. Sometimes you just gotta show people better than you can tell them. And that's where I am right now with this little situation that kind of could have just put me in a negative space. And I was like, no, we're not gonna do that. Say what you say, say what you need to say, say what you mean, put it out there. And literally leave it in God's hands. Literally. So I will see y'all tomorrow.
I'm about to, I forgot to make an appointment for my haircut, so I'm gonna have to text him first thing in the morning. Yeah, I'm ready to take these tights off, y'all. I'm ready to take these tights off. I'm ready to get out this outfit. Now, Mr. Long came and had dinner with me. My husband is my best friend in the whole wide world, y'all. I cannot stress that. When you find a spouse, your spouse literally should be everything to you. They have flaws too, however, they should be everything to you. And y'all, I know my husband, no matter what, he gonna always have my back. And just like that, he was there tonight and he was just like, I think you did the right thing, Steph. Reassurance. Sometimes we even need a healthy dose of that. So I will see y'all in the a.m. Okay. Mm-hmm.